Evet, şimdi arkadaşlar hatırlarsanız kaydı açtım galiba. Evet, bu part 4'e başlamıştık. Son modelleri görüyoruz demiştik burada geçen hafta. Burada gördüğümüz ilk model, bu yeni slaytlarda self service Infinity modelleriydi. MM ya da GG Infinity. Burada bu modellerde arkadaşlar sınırsız sayıda server var. Varsayıyoruz. Yani herkes kendi server'ı. Herkes geliyor sisteme. Kendi işini kendi yapıyor yani. Bir aslında çalışan yok ortalıkta. Dolayısıyla kuyruk da yok. Bunları analiz etmesi en kolay sistemler. Burada fazla bir formül yok. Sadece işte iki tane formül vardı. Ortalama sistemde kaç kişi iş görüyordur? L. Bir sistemde bir kişinin harcadığı süre. Bu da direkt şeye eşitti zaten. İşlem süresine. Çünkü adam geliyor, işini yapıyor, çıkıyor. Ne kadar süre harcar? Bekleme olmadığı için sadece expected service time bir bölümeye. Sadece özel bir formül şey de var. Eğer gelişler Markovian'sa servis süresi önemli değil. Sadece gelişlerin üstel olması yani MG tarzı bir kuyruksa burada şey olduğunu söylemiştik. Sistemde herhangi bir anda J tane şahıs görme olasılığının Python olduğunu. Yani sistemde bir geldiniz self servis sistemine 10 kişi görme ihtimaliniz Python. Pi yerine J'ye 10 yazarsanız onu bulabiliyorduk. Burada bununla alakalı örnekler çözdük. MG1 sonra sizin bu sınıfta göreceğiniz en gelişmiş modellerden biri MG1'i gördük. MG1 model. Burada arkadaşlar şeyi genelleştirdik artık. Servis süresine izin verdik Markov olmamasına. Genel bir hal almasına izin verdik. Ama gelişleri hala Markov'la sınırlandırdık. Aslında daha da bunun genel hali GG1. Fakat biz sizin ona girmiyoruz. Sadece bu modelde bırakıyoruz MG1'da. Yani burada sadece servis süresinin genel hali G General'da hatırlarsanız. Üstelim dışına çıktığımız ilk model. Burada formüllerin nasıl türetildiğine hiç girmedik bile. Çünkü o bizim şeyimiz dışında dedik, kapsamımız dışında dedik. Sadece sonuçları verdim size burada. MG1 kuyruğu için LQ, LWQ, W hesaplarını. Yani bu MG1'daki tek farkın sigması kare olduğunu. Bu da G, servis süresinin varyansı olduğunu, servis süresinin varyansı sigma kare. Buraya zaten sıfır yazarsanız, sigma kare yerine sıfır yazarsanız MD1 oluyor. Deterministik modele dönüşüyor. MD1, MD1. Sigma kare yerine 1 bölü mu kare yazarsanız direkt MM1 formülleri ortaya çıkıyor dedik. MG1 en genel hali olduğu için bunun özel hali oluyor. MM1 bu formüllerin özel bir uygulaması. MD1 bir özel uygulaması oluyor. Bunları biz bir özel örnek üzerinde gösterdik. Sonra size maliyetlerden bahsettik. Yani bir kuyruk tasarımı yapacaksanız iki tane maliyet var birbiriyle çelişen. Bir tanesi bekletme maliyeti müşteri, bir tanesi de servis yani çalışana ödediğiniz para. Çok çalışan aldıkça çalışana ödediğiniz para artıyor tabii ki. Ama müşteriyi daha az bekletiyorsunuz. Burada bu ikisinin toplamına baktığınızda güzel optimize edilecek bir curve çıkıyor ortaya. Bizim amacımız şu minimum noktasını bulmak dedik. Waiting cost'la servis cost'u dengeleyecek bir çalışan sayısını bulmak dedik. Burada servis cost çok kolay dedik. Bu sadece S tane server'ın her birine 5 lira ödüyorsam saatte 5 tane S dedik. Benzer şekilde waiting cost da gayet kolay. Yani çok zor değil. Birim müşteri maliyeti C. Birim müşteri birim zaman maliyeti çarpı kaç tane müşteri var birim zamanda kuyruk sistemde kaç müşteri var bu ikisini toplayarak toplam maliyeti bulduk. Bununla alakalı örnekler çözdük. Bir tane süper kompütür alacaktık, hangisini alalım, biri pahalı ama hızlı, biri ucuz ama yavaş. Bunlardan maliyet hesapları yaparak birine karar verdik. Sonra bir tane daha son örneğimiz de buydu. Bir tane de bir tool center'da makinacı şeyler var. Tool Center'da çalışanlara tool'lar veren bir merkez var. Orada bir kişi çalışıyor şu anda. Onun hızı işte 5 dakikada çalışana ihtiyacı olan tool'u veriyordu. Yanına bir tane çırak alalım mı dedik. Çırağın maliyeti 4 dolardı saatte ama çalışanı hızlandırıyor ve 4 dakikaya düşürüyordu hızını. Yani hızını arttırıyor, servis süresini 4 dakikaya düşürüyordu. Ve bunu alalım mı almayalım mı maliyet hesabı yaptık. Bekletmenin maliyeti vardı burada. Onlardan bir dengeli şey yaparak tool center içinde bir karar vermiştik. Maliyet hesabıyla karar vermiştik. Bu da arkadaşlar diğer örneğimiz. Burada kalmıştık aslında. Burada kalmıştık. Şimdi buradan devam edeceğiz. Bu biraz daha farklı. Şimdi bunu okuyalım beraber. Burada kaldı. Buradan devam edebiliriz artık. Şimdi evet. Burada biraz daha türevlerle gideceğiz buna. Evet. Suppose that it cost C mu dollars per hour to provide service at rate mu. Tamam. Şimdi burada servis İngilizceye geçebiliriz yeni konu olduğu için. Evet. So it cost C mu dollars to provide service at a service provider. So the service cost is a function of mu. As you remember, I told you that this might be possible. In our formulation, let me show you again. We kept this as a function of mu. So this is service cost. How many servers you have times the cost of servers. Now what this problem says is that now the faster the server, the more expensive it is. So it is a function of the service rate, service cost. In the examples, this was fixed for us, $5 per hour. This is how much you pay for the service. But now in this question, what we are saying is that, so to provide a mu rate of service, you need to pay C times mu dollars. Now there is also gross profit of A dollars for each customer that you serve. So you incur a gross profit of A dollars. So everyone that comes to you pays A dollars and then leaves. They come and pay you A dollar and then they leave. So if there is a, this is a capacitated system. So it is a M1N system. It's a capacitated system. What service rate? How should I choose mu to maximize my profit? So how can you write your profit? So profit is equal to income minus outcome, right? So income comes from the customers, outcome from the servers. So from each customer, you get paid A dollars. Assume the arrival rate is lambda to the system, but do I accept every one of them? Am I able to process every customer in a capacitated system or not? So this is a limited system. And outside, yes.
We are not able to accept
yes, everyone. Very good. So remember, in a capacitated system, even if this is the actual, this is the arrival rate from outside, we cannot accept. Sometimes we reject because the system is full. Do you remember what we called the actual arrival rate? We called it lambda actual. This is the actual number of people that you can accept into your system. Lambda actual. Do you remember what was the formula for lambda actual? Does anybody remember? Lambda times probability of acceptance, which is probability that system is not full.
Hocam, burada bir kişi bir server olduğunu nerede anladık dedi.
Yes, you are right. It doesn't clearly specify that. You are right. It should say it more clearly. Yes, that's correct. It doesn't clearly say that. But it doesn't say there is two. We automatically assume it is one. But it should have said clearly that there is one server. That's correct. And it actually should also say that everything is exponential. It doesn't also say that. We automatically assumed these things. But you are right. The problem should mention specifically that arrivals are exponential so that I can say M. Service is exponential. There is one server. Yes, it only says this last piece of information. The others is not given. Okay. So do you remember in a capacitated system, what was the probability of actual arrival rate?
Lambda çarpı 1 eksi pi j n
pi n. Yes, very good. 1 minus pi c capacitated. So pi c is the probability that the system is full. So c was the capacity. So you said n. That's very good. So you realize capacity is n. So we should update our formula. And we should say pi n, right? This is the capacity because In our formulation, we represented capacity by C, but in this problem, it says it represents capacity by N. It doesn't matter. It is just a matter of notation. It is not important. Some books like to represent it by capital N. Some books represent by C. It doesn't matter. The result is the same. So this is the how much you can actually process per time unit. So how much money you make because of this? How much money you make? So since everybody pays $8, if in 1 hour, how much? So this is how much customer arrives per time unit, per, let's say per hour. So this is per hour, everything per hour. So this is how many customers arrive per hour to your company. So they, how much revenue do you make money? You need to simply multiply this to obtain the revenue. You need to multiply this by A, which is how much each customer pays. Lambda times 1 minus pi n. So this is revenue, but I want to find profit. How do you find profit? So to find profit, what should I do? So let's say to calculate profit. So revenue minus your spendings. So you spend only service, right? You spend only for the servers. And how much do you pay per hour? So it's already here. You pay C times mu per hour. So this is the formula for your profit, okay? So we just need to remember the formula for pi n and put it here. So the formula for pi n is given in the slides in the previous sections. So I'm just going to clear this. So this is how much money we make per hour. And we also need to pay for the service. And that's how much we pay. This is how much we get. This, the difference is our profit. Now, to find the, so we need to just plug in the formula for pi n. This formula for pi n, we have it in the slides, okay? This is the probability of having n customers in a capacitated system. In our slide, it might be represented by pi c, because we denoted the capacity by c. So this might be in terms of c in our slides. It doesn't matter. So once you plug in everything, now here, how can you optimize this? Now here, everything is given. So everything is given except mu. I want, this is a function of mu from calculus, remember. This is a function of mu, and we can optimize this, remember, by integration. So if you want to optimize a function, find the optimal point. Remember, not integration, I am sorry, differentiation. We differentiate and find, set it equal to zero and solve for mu. I think you remember this from the calculus class, right? If you want to find this point, I'm sorry. So if you want to find a point like this, the derivative should be equal to zero at these points with respect to mu. So for this special case where the parameters are given to us, mu, so in this special case, you get $10 per customer. Service cost is directly proportional to the mu, $1 for each service rate, and capacity is 2. If you put this and integrate, set equal to 0, then solution solving for mu gives you the desired result. It will not be integer, obviously. It might be some number, but if you solve this for mu, you will get the desired result. So which value of mu optimizes this profit? Do you have any questions on this one? Any questions? Okay. If you don't have any questions, we can solve the next one. This is about the optimum number of tellers. If there is no questions, we can go to the next one. Okay. So bank staffing problem. So let's look at this one together. So the manager of a bank must determine how many tellers should work on Fridays. For every minute a customer stands in line, the manager believes that a delay cost of 5 cents is incurred. So if you make a customer wait, he calculates, he believes that you are, so this is difficult to quantify. This number is most difficult thing to quantify. How much does it cost me to make a customer wait? Waiting cost per customer, per time minute. So this is per minute, 5 cents per minute, per customer. An average 2 customers per minute arrive to the bank. So there are 2 customers arriving to the bank per minute. And it takes 2 minutes to process a customer transaction. It costs the banks $9 to hire a teller, $9. Everything is exponential. To minimize the sum of service and delay cost, how many tellers should we have? Do you understand the question? So what kind of queuing system is this?
MG.
So, but inter-arrival times, service times are exponential, means that we are still in good place. We are still good. It is MM, inter-arrival exponential, service time exponential means we are fine. So this is MM model, first of all. Now, the question is actually about the last part. Last part, this is the question. Because the problem is, how many workers should I have? The problem is optimizing these numbers. So we cannot say it is MM1, MM2, MM3. The question wants us to find the best number of tellers. How many tellers means how many servers? Number of servers, right? So how many servers should I have? How many servers should I have? This is the question. So, okay, let's keep it as it is. And let's say, what is lambda here? What is the arrival rate? How many? Yes, very good. 2 per minute. Arrival rate, nice. So what about mu per teller? How fast is 1 teller? What's the service rate?
7/2.
Very good. So 1/2 per minute, right? Because 2 minutes to complete 1 customer. So the service rate will be 1/2 per minute. Now everything is minutes, so we don't need to change it anything. Everything is in terms of, except this one. $9 per hour. So we have a problem here. But other than that, the cost is minute. So this one, except this one, everything seems to be minutes. So 1/2 per minute. So first of all, is this system stable? Lambda over mu, is it less than one? Let's check it. So 2/1/2 is equals to 4. So what are we gonna do? This is not stable. This is bigger than one.
S should be more than 4.
Yes, very nice. So remember, for multiple servers, the actual actual condition becomes like this: lambda over S times mu, because you have S workers. So this should be less than one. So S should be bigger than lambda over mu, right? So which is equal to 4. So how many servers do I need at least? At least, so what are the possible values for S then?
5.
Yes, it starts with 5. It can go up to as much as you want, right? So minimum I need 5 for stable system. Anything less than 5, it doesn't work for me. So what to do next? Now, you don't need to do any differentiation, So there, since there are discrete possibilities, 5, 6, 7, there is only finite possibilities. What you should do is you should try every one of them, starting with 5, calculate cost for MM5, total cost, and then calculate total cost for MM6, and then MM7. Once it starts increasing, let's say this is low, and MM6 is bigger than this, you can stop, because it will continue to increase. Because the concave structure of this cost function. So the once you find the minimum point, we can stop searching for the best S, best number of servers. Okay, so I'm going to erase everything here. Okay, so we can do calculation of total cost for the special case of, we can start with 5. So we can start with calculating the total cost for MM5 system. Now, total cost consists of, remember, waiting cost plus service cost. Now, the easy part is the service cost. How much do we pay for service in MM5 system?
~9/60 mı?
Yes, very good. So 9/60 per minute times. So we can call TC5 actually, because this is the total cost for 5 servers. We can call it TC5. So 9/60 per minute per server, but I have 5 of them. So this is, will be this service cost. Okay. And waiting cost, if you remember, customer cost 5 times LQ, time in queue. Correct?
Hocam 0.5 olmayacak mı? 5 cent diyor
ya. Ah, you are right. You are. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Nice. 0.05. Very good. So we forgot to change, forget to change cent into dollars. That's absolutely right. $0.05, right? 5 cents means. So did we forget anything else? Other than that, it's good, right? So the problem is this LQ. But this is not a problem, because we did many examples of how to find LQ for an MMS system. It is just a long calculation, but it is doable. So let's check the solution already. So yes, we need to compare the cost for different values of S, and expected cost here is also, they also calculated expected service cost here and expected delay cost here. So what we want here is the LQ, and we have this space is better. So maybe I can write somewhere cleaner. So let's write somewhere. So total cost will be 0.05 LQ plus 9/45/60. So this is in terms of per minute. This much cost is incurred in the bank per minute, every minute. We kept everything in terms of minutes. So the question is this one, LQ. For TC5. So for corresponding the 5 servers, we need this. And which is not difficult for S equal to 5. Let me erase this part so that we can see the calculations. So remember, for MMS system in the formulas, we need some quantity called this one, probability that the system is full. And this is what they did is they read this from the table. Remember, MMS calculating this was difficult, and I showed you a table. You can calculate this by definition using the formula. It takes some time, or you can use a table. There was a table in the slides which automatically calculates this quantity for you for different number of servers, for different utilizations, for different rows. So corresponding to 0.8 and number of servers 5, this probability is 0.55, and corresponding WQ is this. Now W, after finding WQ, remember LQ is simply lambda times WQ, which is equal to 2 times 1.1. So we can put this back into the formula and calculate the total expected cost, which turns out to be, after some calculations, 86 cents. 86 cents. And seeing, doing the same thing for 6 servers, it turns out to be 90 cents. Since it started increasing immediately with one more teller, we can stop. We can say that S equal to 5 gives you the minimum total queuing cost, total service cost. Yes.
Kaçırdım da bu 0.10 nereden geldi? 1
So waiting cost is lambda times LQ, right? C times LQ waiting cost. So in this case, they solved this by like this: C times lambda times WQ. Okay. So remember, C is 0.05. Lambda is 2, right? And WQ is 1.1. So this multiplication here is 0.10 times 1.1. Okay? So this formula can be done both ways because of Little's law. You can either say C times LQ, or you can say C times lambda times WQ. So they are using this one. It doesn't matter. They are the same thing. Okay, let's continue. Do we have time? Yes, we have time. Are there any other questions? Okay, no other questions. Then we can do the next one. Okay. So next one doesn't have the solution. We need to write it down. How many examples we have left? This job shop, unisex hair shop, milling machines, and we have 3 examples left. Okay, let's do, how much time we have? Yes, 10 minutes. So maybe we cannot finish this, but at least we can start the job shop. So in a job shop, workers use the same tool. On average, 2 workers need the tool per minute. Okay, what is this tool? So this is difficult to understand the problem sometimes. What does 2 represent here? What do you think 2 is? So 2 workers need the tool per minute. So let's read the whole question, then I will ask one by one. In a job shop, workers use the same tool. There is one tool and workers need it, okay? Someone borrows the tool. 2 workers need it every minute, pass on, distributed. And once when someone takes this tool, let's say it is a driller, drilling machine. There is one driller only in the company. People borrow it, use it, and then someone else borrows it, okay? They use it only for 40 seconds, and then they are done. Usage time is also random, which is exponential. There is no actual machine, there is no actual server, but you can think of tool as the machine serving the worker. So drilling machine, when it goes to the worker, and the worker is using the tool, the tool is busy, right? Everyone else needs to wait their turn. So there is a queue to use this tool. So you can observe queues in front of the tool, so because others need it, right? So how many tools needed for the system to be stable? Okay, first of all, what kind of system do we have here? What kind of queuing system is this? Any guess?
MG miydi hocam?
So let's think about together. First of all, there is arrivals, right? What are customers? Who are the customers here? What are
workers değil mi hocam?
Yes, workers are the customers, right? Very good. So they are customers and they come, they need the tool, right? How fast do they come? What is lambda here? What is lambda?
2 dakikada 2'ymiş.
Two workers need the tool per minute. Yes, very good. Two per minute. Yes, two customers need the tool per minute. This is lambda. And it says it is Poisson distributed. So what does Poisson distributed means? Arrivals are exponential. So clearly I am in an M situation. Arrivals are exponential. So let's look at the service side. How is the server working? So you can think of 40 seconds as the service time because they are with the tool for 40 seconds. Even though the worker is using the tool you can think of as the server because they spend together 40 seconds. So 40 seconds is like processing time. Okay, and which is exponential means that we are still in an MM situation. Arrival exponential, service is exponential. Number of servers is the problem, actually. So because it says how many tools, how many servers should I have so that I have a stable system. So lambda is 2 per minute. What about mu? What is mu?
1.5.
Sorry. 1.5. Let's check. It might be. Okay. So mu is so we can say so it is 40 second is the service time, right? So the rate will be 1/40 per seconds, right? So since they are in different units, I need to multiply. How do I convert to minutes?
60 çarpacağız.
Yes, 60 times 1/40 1 minute. Yes, it is 1.5, right? I think if you divide this by this, you will get 1.5 or 3/2, 1.5 per minute. Now we are so everything is in terms of same units, so we are good. Everything is minutes, which is nice. So first part, question number one. How many tools are needed for the system to be stable? So what does stable mean? Stable means, maybe I can solve it here. So stable means lambda over S mu should be less than one, right? Which means lambda is, what is lambda? 2 divided by S times 1.5 should be less than 1, which means S should be bigger than 2 divided 1.5, which is 4/3. So how should I select S? What is the choice of S? S should be, how many tools are needed? Minimum number of tools, let's say. What is the minimum number of tools needed? So how should, if I want the minimum, how should I select S?
We can select 2.
You said 2, Batural?
Evet.
2 ve üstü değil mi?
Yes, minimum is 2, but more than 2 is enough. Yes, very good. Thank you. Yes, we can select 2 or more tools because this is 1 point something, right? But we cannot have this many tools. We can only have integer number 2, 3 or 4. So which means that I need to at least two. Three is also fine. Four is fine, but this is the at least minimum. Okay, so if that many tools are used, B, part B. If that many tools are used, what is the probability that all the tools are in use? Okay, so we are in part B. If that many tools are used, then it means we are in MM2. Our system
becomes... Hocam, that many derken bizim seçtiğimiz rakam mı? 3'ü de seçebilirdik mesela.
This good question, Burak. Yes. Actually, it should clearly say so minimum, let's say minimum, we assume minimum number of tools used, if minimum number of necessary tools used. Okay, because otherwise it is, there are infinite possibilities, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this question somewhere should have mentioned that we want the minimum number of tools necessary. Okay, so we can automate. So S bigger than, so 2, 3, 4, 5 is okay. But what we are interested in is the least number of tools necessary, so because they don't want to spend a lot of money, let's say, assume. They don't want to buy a lot of, what is the minimum number of tools necessary? So we are in MM2. So what is this probability about? What is B about? Probability that all tools are in use. Remember, in MMS system, there is a quantity called in the formulas, there was something. What represents the probability that all tools are in use? What notation? Huh? All good. Can you repeat? Yes, very good. Probability that J bigger than or equal to 2. Do you remember this? We actually did this.
Tablodan baktığımız yer değil mi?
Yes, this is the one we can look at in from the table. That's correct. We actually did this in this previous problem. Where did we do it? We needed this somewhere right now. I think in this question, right? But I cannot find it now. We did this for this one. Yes, here. This probability J bigger than number of servers. This is from the form. There is a formula for this. You can calculate this from the formula. For this formula, you need the row. Okay, or you can use the table, whichever. If it is not in the table, you have to use the formula.
Hocam, az önceki soruyla alakalı biz hani 5'i seçmiştik en düşük olarak. Hani orada biz şey yapmadık, hangisi en düşük buluyor diye hepsini yerine koyarak mı yaptık?
Yes, that's good question. Now, this doesn't say you need to select the minimum number of tellers. It says calculate minimum cost. If the waiting the customer is too costly, maybe 6 tellers would be optimal. There is a balance, okay? Now, this is not about cost. This problem is not about cost. There is no waiting cost. We just want a stable system. We don't care about the cost. That's why we want just the minimum necessary, okay? Assume there is no cost for making the workers wait. But in this problem, in the bank example, there is a waiting cost. So sometimes having more servers might be better. You don't want the customers to wait a lot. Here, yes, 5 tellers was enough, but it might be possible if this cost was high enough, this 5 cents, it is very low. 5 cents waiting cost is very low. Let's say it was 10 cents or 20. There is a turning point where you want to have more. Compared to the teller cost, which is $9, this 5 cents is low. That is why the bank operates at the minimum level of tellers. Okay, is it clear? Okay.
Yani so, biz mesela 5'in için hesaplayacağız, 6 için hesaplayacağız. Hangisi en düşükse onu seçeceğiz.
Yes, that's correct. Let's say 5, 4, 5, it is, let's say it is $7 for 5 servers, for 5 tellers. For 6 tellers, let's say it is $4. For seven tellers, let's say it is $5. Then it, once it starts increasing, it will continue increasing. 6, 9. So you want to find this minimum point. So what
biz
I am.
Az önce bunu bulduk mu peki? Az önce sanki bir tane demiştim.
No, we also did 6. We saw that it is increasing and then we stopped. So let me show you. We didn't do detailed analysis. I just showed you the result. That's why.
Anladım, tamam. Altıda direkt bozulduğu için zaten biz direkt 5 seçtik.
Yeah, so just S6 is here. So for S equal to 6, it already increased 90 cents. So 86 to 90. So we just stopped. Once it starts increasing, we stop. We don't try more than 6. There is no need because I know that S7 will be more than 90 cents because it started increasing now. That's why is that? Because of this structure of total cost. Let me show you how much. Okay, here. It's not clear, but this structure, you see, there is one point and it starts increasing because of this shape of total cost. Once you find the minimum point, if it starts increasing, the next points will always be bigger than the previous one. Okay, so how much time we have? We don't have time. Let's give a break. Let's give a 10-minute break and I will see you in 10 minutes. Is there any other questions? Are there?
Hocam, sınıf çalışması Perşembe günkü Queening'le mi alakalı olacak?
Evet, Queening gene. Yani geçen seferki queuing değildi aslında, Poisson prosesti. Bakar, queuing'e tam başlamamıştık. Bu sefer artık queuing sorabiliriz. Yani gene queuing konusundan. Evet, başka soru var mı arkadaşlar? Tamam, o zaman recording'i durduruyorum. So we are going to continue as where we stopped. So we are solving this problem. Okay, so we want to find probability that J is bigger than or equal to 2 for an MM2 system. So let's clear a little bit, do some cleaning. So J bigger than, so first of all, what we need is rho, which is lambda over S. So we want lambda over S times mu. So this is going to be lambda over S mu. To find this number, it will be, so lambda was 2, S is 2, mu is 1.5. 2 divided by 3. Right, is this correct? I think that's correct, right? So we just need to use the formula. I am not going to write down. So we have the formula using these lambda, mu, and rho. This turns out to be, this probability turns out to be 0.533. Okay, so again, as I told you, I am not doing it all the way. There's this long formula. We just plug it in. It is in the slides in the previous sections. The important part is what does the problem wants from us, to find what does the problem wants. After that, it is just some calculations. So let's look at C. So what is the average queue length of workers? So what does this part wants? What? So in which performance measure are we interested in this time?
LQ.
Yes, very good. So we are interested in LQ, which is a very easy matter. Once you have this, this is not very difficult. It is just a matter of plugging in the formula. Again, it turns out to be 2.44, because you can check these calculations. As I told you, we did many examples like this, MMS examples. Let's do part D.
Hocam neyle neyi çarpıp onu bulmuştuk?
2.4.
Aha. 0.533 mi?
So it is so I didn't write the formula here, but MMS formula you can use this WQ. Okay, so there is formula is here. So it is rho. So if you can get this, what is the formula? We have here this probability divided by S times. So this is from this equation, and this should be, what is this? Lambda, I think. So I don't remember the formula, exact formula, but we just need to plug in this in here. We just need to plug it in here. Okay. What was the formula here for WQ? So we can go check our slides. Go back and check our slides. I just wrote the results here. That's why I don't have the formulas right now. Or we can go to the, I think it was in the previous slides. So let's go back to the previous slides. Let me open them up. I will share with you because I don't remember the formula and I didn't take note of that. Okay, so it should be here somewhere. So here is the MMS model. So this is the formula. So it was easy. I think it, so it seems like it is not difficult. So this is the formula here for MMS system. And so in our problem, what was probability? This probability was 0.533. And what was rho? We calculated rho to be 2.3. Divide by 1 minus 2.3, I think, right? Something like that. So they use this formula. And we can also calculate pi zero for this problem, for this MMS situation. Pi zero is here. Pi zero calculation is here. This is the longest part, actually. And in this problem that we are solving, pi zero turns out to be, what does pi zero represent? Do you remember?
Sistemde kimsenin olmaması.
Yes, so it's proved that the system is empty. This is the most difficult part actually. Look at this one. The longest one in MMS is pi zero. Actually, you have everything. You just need to plug it in. In our example, S is 2. Lambda is, what was lambda? Lambda is 2 per minute. Mu is 3 over 2 per minute, 1.5 per minute. So it is just a matter of some, yes, it is possible to make mistakes because it is very long. It's possible, very possible to make some calculation errors, but it is a matter of calculation and putting things together. Once you figure out, these formulas will be with you everywhere in the exam or so you just need to find the correct formula to use. Which one is the correct? As I told you before. So let's go to our previous problem, Japsha problem. And let's make this big screen and let's share this big screen. Okay, so we have done almost, so we were saying that for part C, we want LQ. And LQ turns out to be 2.4 according to this formula I just showed you for the MMS system. What is L then? Okay, let's go to the next one, D, part D. What is the average number of workers in the system? So this one is asking LQ. What about this one? Number of workers in the system.
Hocam
So what does it want from us? What do you think? Number, so it is number, it is either. So number means it is not time, it's not W. So in system means this one, this time it wants us to find L. So L is pretty easy from LQ, remember? So when it says number in system, it includes number in Q plus number in service. So if you remember, so part D, L is equal to LQ plus LS. So it's 2.4 plus LS. So what was LS for a MMS system? Do you remember? Number of people in service. Length of server. It was, do you remember the formula for this one? Lambda over mu. So lambda over mu will be L of S, which is equal to lambda is 2, mu is 3 over 2, which is 4 over 3. Okay, so this is going to be 4 over 3. What about E? Average time a worker spends in the system. So it is time related to time. So what should I
say? W değil mi hocam?
Yes, very good. So this is W. And so remember, if you calculated just one performance measure using the formula, the rest you shouldn't do it. You should just use Little Slow. So W is simply equal to, as you remember from Little Slow says that L equals lambda times W. So W will be L divided by lambda. So you already have the L here calculated. I didn't write the final answer, but we already write the L. Now it is 3.73. So I have it in my notes. So this means that this is equal to 373 divided by lambda, which is lambda was 2. So it will turn out to be 1.2. What is the result here? L divided by lambda. So if you divide this, it's around more than 1.5, right? Something, so I didn't do this division, but so what we want is L. Let's keep it like this, you can do the division. So let's do F, part F. These are easy questions, as you can see. These are not very difficult, just standard applications. What is the average time a worker spends in the queue? Now this time, this is WQ, okay? So time in queue, remember, is WQ. So you can go to WQ in many different ways. There are many ways. You can go to WQ from LQ, or you can go to WQ from W, whichever you like. This way, it is called Little Slow. Remember, LQ is equal to lambda times WQ. You can use this. Or remember that total time in system is time in queue plus time in service. Or you can use this one, whichever you like. So WQ will be simply W minus 1 over mu. We already have everything because remember mu is already calculated for us. Mu is already known. So we just need to put, by the way, what will be the units here? Units of this W. Maybe we can write the units. It is important. It will be hours. Or what?
Dakika değil mi hocam?
Yes, very good. Dakika. Because everything here, we working on minutes, right? The time units here, everywhere is minutes. So these will have minutes, time units. Very nice. Very good. Do you have any question on this one? This was standard application of an MMS example. There is nothing special here. Just application of formulas, standard. But still, do you have any questions? We can look at them if you have any. Okay, so I am going to clear the board and continue with the next example. This is also standard example. I just put these extra examples so that you have more insights. By the way, all these examples, the last ones I show you, you will see them again in simulation. Most of these examples will come back to you in the simulation class, especially this one, this unisex shop, job shop, tool shop. These are same examples as we use in the simulation. Unisex hair styling shop can hold only 3 customers. One in service, 2 waiting. Okay. Okay, let's read this together and then try to find an answer. So again, it's a barber shop. And again, there is a limited space, which reminds us that this is a capacitated system. Barber shops, remember, we like these examples as a capacitated systems because, you know, barber shops actually has limited seats, right? If people doesn't want to wait standing, if they want to sit, there is only limited seats available if you want to get a haircut. So look at this barber shop. It can only hold 3 customers. So they can only have maximum 3 customers. 1 in service, 2 waiting. Additional customers are rejected when the system is full. Time between arrivals is 1/2 hours, exponential. Service time is 20 minutes, exponential. Compute these things. Okay. So what kind of queuing system is this? We did a similar example actually, but this is maybe extra. Maybe this one is an extra, but still, what are we talking about here? We did the same barber shop, barber. This time it is unisex hair shop. We did a similar one. So it can only hold 3 customers, mean it is a capacitated system. There is only 1 barber, hair cutter. Because there is only 1 people can be in service. 2 of them are waiting, sitting in line. So this is a very simple. So, and everything is exponential. Arrival service. So we are in the case of MM1. What about the capacity? What should I write? 2 or 3? For capacity, should I write 2 or 3? Okay, what do you think?
3 değil mi hocam? Sistemde olduğu için.
Yes, 3. The difference is you need to count the 1 in service plus waiting spaces. So the 1 in the service is considered in the system. So capacity will be 3. So this is a capacitated system, MM1-3. And lambda is equal to what here in this example. So time between arrivals is 30 minutes, 1.5 hours. Which means lambda will be
20/30 mu?
Yes, 30 minutes. So it will be 1/30 per minute or 1/1/2 per hour. Which will be 2 per hour. Think about it. If there is 1 customer every 30 minutes, in 1 hour, you will have 2 customers. So this is the arrival rate. Service rate will be 20 minutes. Okay, service time is 20 minutes. So it will be 1/20 per minute. It will be 60/20 per hour. It will be 3 per hour. So we have lambda and we have mu. Okay, so lambda and mu is here. Number of servers is 1. Capacity of the system is 3. And the rho in the formulas is lambda over mu, which is 2 divided by 3. This is in the formulas, rho. You see everywhere. That's why I put it here. So again, I am not going to write the formulas in the long. The formulas are in the slides. You can check. You just need to plug in these parameters in the formulas. Okay, I am not going to do it in the long version. So let's do what the question wants from us. Number A, proved that the system is full. So you need to go look at the MM1 C model formulas. We are using these formulas. So part A, proved that the system is full. So what do we want here?
P, J,
so yes,
üçten büyük mü?
So we want pi C, simply pi C. Remember, in a Kappa state system, or we can write it as we want pi 3. So probability of having 3 customers. So pi 4, pi 5, these are 0. These are 0. Because you cannot have 4 customers or 5. The only positive pi's are pi 0, pi 1, pi 2, and pi 3. Because there can be only 3 customers. So what we want, the system is full when there are 3 customers. So we want this number. Okay. So you can calculate pi 3 using using pi 0. And pi 0 in this problem turns out to be 0.415. So again, it is just plugging in the formulas for the MMC from the MM1CQ, and pi 3 will be 0.125. So system is full this much of the time. Part B, average length of Q. So this is simply, what do we want here? Average length of Q is length of Q, LQ, length of Q. And again, this turns out to be for an MM1-3 system, 0.431 customers in the queue. So this system is underutilized. There are 2 seats and you just need one. One of them is empty most of the time. This is not a popular shop. As well as the previous one. It was very popular. This one is not. C, effective arrival rate.
Lambda Q.
Yes, lambda actual. Effective means lambda actual. Yes, lambda actual, very good. So this is lambda times 1 minus system is full. So lambda is 2, 1 minus pi 3, which turns out to be 1.754 per hour. Okay, still we reject some customers, even though we are not at full capacity. It seems it is possible to reject. So we are still not accepting everyone. 1.75, because 2 customers arrive every hour and I only accept some of them. Actually, most of them, but I reject some of them. Okay, part D. Time in queue and total time in shop, which is easy, right? WQ, time in queue, and total time in shop is simply W, as usual. Since you have LQ from here, this question, WQ is simply LQ divided by lambda. Lambda or what? I did a mistake. What should I write here? What is, I did a mistake in part D. What is my mistake?
Çarpım olması gerekmez miydi hocam?
No, this lambda is actual. Yes, that's correct. So I should write lambda actual. No, the formula is fine. Lambda L equals lambda times W, little slow is this. That's fine, but remember in this system, I should always use actual lambda. Okay, in the little slow, this is the mistake. So 0.431 divided by, which is 0.246 hours. Okay, so W, you can go different ways to go to W, but the simplest it seems is this one. Time in queue plus service time is simplest. This much time in system. And do we need anything else? Okay, last one. service utilization. Okay, how should we do it? How should I do it? Service utilization.
Alakalı bir şey.
Yes, utilization in a normal MM1 system, utilization is this. Lambda over mu. This is utilization. But in this system, how can I do it? So in a normal system, it is lambda divided by mu.
Lambda eksi mu yapacağız?
Yes, there are different ways you can do it. You can do it by lambda actual divided by mu, or there is one more way. So yes, utilization, you can say lambda customer comes and my service rate is this much, so I work only this much of the time. Berber is busy this percentage of time. Lambda actual is 1.754 and service rate is 3. Or there is one more way. Utilization is equal to one minus non-busy, pi zero. Remember, pi zero means the server is idle, sitting empty, doing nothing in pi zero. So one minus idle gives you busy. So the server is utilized, busy, 1 minus pi 0 percentage of the time is another way to say it. Okay, both of them are fine. Okay, do you have any question on this example? Any questions?
Bunu sadece MM1 olduğu için kullanabiliyoruz değil mi?
Hangisini?
Şu olsa 1 eksi pi 0'ı daha farklı yazmamız gerekiyor değil mi?
Utilization mı?
Yani bir server olduğu için.
Evet. Ha, bir server olduğu için 1 eksi pi 0, evet. İki server olsa, çünkü pi 1'deyken de bir tanesi boş kalabiliyor ya. Evet, bir tane. Çünkü bir müşteri varsa bile kimin çalıştığı belli yani. Bir tane berber var, o çalışacak. İki tane berber olsa işler değişiyordu. Evet. Evet, başka sorunuz var mı arkadaşlar? Tamam. O zaman herhalde ya son ya da iki example'ımız kaldı. 15 dakikamız var. Güzel. Yani zaten hedefim bu slide'ları bitirmekti. Yeni slide başlamayı düşünmüyordum. Evet, son example'ımız kalmış. Evet. Sorunuz yoksa siliyorum arkadaşlar tahtayı. Okay. So last example for today. Last one. Okay, then you are free. You can go. You are free to go. Okay, so there are two workers. There are who are responsible for 10 milling machines. Machines work for average. Okay, this one is the. Which model is this one? So there are two workers who only look for 10 machines. Machines work for an average of 20 minutes. Then they require 5 minutes of service time. Everything is exponential. Only 10 elite customers. Okay, what kind of model is this one?
MCKK.
Yes, that's correct. This is a finite population example. Remember, we did an example actually. This is an extra. This is very similar actually. It is just an extra example. This is the Batman, Gotham City Police Department. 5 police cars. So this is 10 cars. There are 10 machines that they look after. It is the same thing. Here we have two workers. There were also two workers in this example. Now we have 10 customers. So we are in the MM2-10-10 model. Yes, this is K. This is K. This is number of servers. Okay. Remember, if this system is finite population, capacity is automatically is 10. Do you remember why? Because you cannot have 11 people in the system. There is only 10 potential customers. Even if everyone is in your shop, it will be 10. 11 is impossible. So the lambda is in this question. Arrival rate is, so they work for 20 minutes means that 1 over 20 per minute. Okay, service rate is 1 over 5 per minute. I am not even converting to hour. Maybe we should convert, I don't know. Hour would be integer. Converting might look better if you convert. Or you can work with minutes. It is up to you. And k is equal to 10. Again, formulas are in the slides. Our objective is to see what the question wants. We are not going to apply the formulas in length. Formulas, as I told you, are available in the previous slides. We are just going to look at what the question wants from us. So the first one, average queue length. What do we want here?
LQ,
yes, because it's Q length. So because it is length and it is related to Q, it is length of Q, LQ. So A, in part A, we want LQ. And LQ, if you remember, we need to use this formula for LQ. I just remind you, we need to multiply N minus 2 times pi of N. N from 2 to 10. Because if there are two customers, this represents the number in queue. This is the probability of having N customers. So remember, this is like an expected value. We talked about this in the finite system case. Having this many people in the queue times probability of having this many people. This is like expected value. And we just need to find pi N for this system, and it is also in the formulas. Pi n's are given in terms of pi zero as a function of pi zero, given in the in these slides. And pi zero, you can calculate in this case, turns out to be this number. It is just, look at these slides. You will see it is just putting in these numbers, lambda, m, q, and s. We have two servers. If you plug these in numbers in the formulas, you can find pi zero. And from here, you can go to pi n's. And from here, you can calculate the average length of Q, which turns out to be 1.46. As I told, I am not going to get into details of the formulas. There is no need. It is the simple algebra. It requires some time, that's it. And number B, effective arrival rate. So lambda is this, but what does effective mean?
Lambda true.
Yes, so actually in this case, effective in this finite system means average lambda. So lambda average. Remember, in the finite system, lambda continues, changes for each state. Lambda 5, lambda 4, lambda. Look at the Batman example. So for each system, there is a different arrival rate. So we calculated the average arrival rate. We called it also lambda actual, maybe. Yes, you are right. Or we called it lambda bar for this finite system, average, weighted average of lambdas. And it was simply lambda j times pi j. You can also check this from the discussion of our discussion. And once we solved for lambda actual, you just need to plug in these definitions of lambda j. Okay. Do you remember what was the formula? Do you remember this turned out to be something, average lambda? K minus L times lambda. Was it this one? Well, it was something like this, right? Or if you don't remember the formula, we can go the long way. It is like this, j from 0 to k. Lambda j is simply lambda times k minus j. These are all in this slides where we discuss finite capacity system, especially Batman example. And this turns out to be 0.342 per minute. So remember, how does finite system works? There are 10 machines. They work for 20 minutes, 10 machines. And every 20 minutes on average, one machine breaks down and comes to your workers for repair. After being repaired, they go into service again. So it is like this. So when they are broken, they come to the queuing system for repair, to be repaired. Okay, so pi zero represents situation that every machine is working and up. Pi 10 represents situation where all 10 machines are broke. Okay, everything is broken and they need to be repaired. So this is how finite system works. What about waiting time in queue? So waiting time in queue will be simply WQ, right? Since we have LQ here, we can use Liddle's law as usual. But here, again, we need to be careful. We use lambda average. So for this system, again, we should use the actual lambda or lambda bar, whichever you like to call. This turns out to be 4.27 minutes. Okay, number D, expected number of machines being serviced or waiting to be serviced. Actually, I already gave you the, so actually I shouldn't have given this to you, right? Okay, assume that this is not given. So what does it want? Expected number of machines being serviced or waiting to be serviced. So these, what we want.
LQRTLS.
Yes, LQR plus LS, that's correct. So what we want is machines that are in the shop to be repaired or being repaired, which is simply L or LQ plus LS, as you said, which is total number of machines in this system, okay? Or we can use the formula for the finite systems for calculating L, which was, what was which, or do you remember the formula? It was J times pi J, J from 0 to 10, which turns out to be 3.17. So what does it mean? So on average, these many machines are in the shop. They need to be repaired, these many shops. So last one, A, so we are in the last case. Number of running machines. Number of machines, they are fine. They are not broken. Number of machines that are fine. How can we find this? So there are total of 10 machines. Out of 10 machines, this many is in the shop being repaired or waiting to be repaired. This many is broken. This much is broken. This much total number of machines. So K minus L will give me what? K minus L. This gives me number of good machines. Okay, which is 6.83 machines. So on average, 6.83 machines are fine and working order. The others is in the shop being repaired or waiting to be repaired. Okay, do you have any questions for today?
Hocam, bu DBL'yi bulurken LF ve LS toplayarak da bulabildik. Oradaki LS yerine yine lambda bölünmüyor mu yazacak? Finite sistemler için.
LS, so let's check. So LS is equal to, so you're saying that LS is equal to lambda over mu, but we should use lambda actual, right? What was lambda actual?
Lambda'nın ortalama değerini mi mu'ya bölecek?
Yes, so we have divide by what is mu?
1 bölü 5 dakikada hocam.
Yes, 0.2. Can you do this division? Can someone do this? Evet. Bunu buna bölersek kaç çıkıyor?
1.71 buldum hocam.
Çok güzel. Evet, 1.71. Evet. Bu şekilde de LS'i bularak da aslında daha kolay, haklısın. LS'i de LQ'ya ekleyebilirdik. Çünkü buradan bunu confirm ettik. LS'le, yani şununla LQ'yu toplarsak LQ neredeydi? LQ?
Ben A çıktığında 1.46.
Evet. L kaç çıkmıştı? 3.17 değil mi? Tamam, 3.17 L çıktı. LS de burada, LQ da burada. Toplarsanız confirm ediyor değil mi?
Ediyor hocam.
Tamam. Evet, o şekilde de yapabilirdiniz. Başka soru var mı arkadaşlar? Tamam. Başka soru yoksa Perşembe günü görüşmek üzere. Şeyi unutmayın. İkinci saatte sınıf çalışmamız var. Herkese iyi günler arkadaşlar.
İyi günler hocam.
İyi günler hocam.
İyi günler.